Now, in part one, Mavournee here told this amazing joke, but didn't give the punchline. And now she's about to give
I'm about to give
us...
you the punchline. So if you're just watching part two, you're going to have to go over to part one to get the first part of the joke, or it's not going to make sense. So the punchline is...
Oh, God, I'm not...
Well...
I'm not... What if I don't laugh?
It's the story of my life. I don't laugh at anything that anyone says to me. Because I'm funny. So then, the polar bear replies, well, my ma had them, then my pa had them.
I can hear crickets. Anyway, William says...
William.
Well, I am.
Do you think Paul should be with Therese instead of Gary?
I think...
She should be with... Oh, wait.
Gary.
To you. Yes.
She should be with Gary.
I agree.
It was for so many reasons. One, Xanthi and I would be stepsisters. Two, Gary's done nothing but love her and be supportive for her.
Three.
It's not Paul.
Four. That's it. Just three.
He's humble.
I said sit down. Be humble.
And also, Paul's just like, no. I mean, I get that there's like a spark and you've all seen it between Paul and Therese, but Gary, what's their ship name? Gary and Therese.
To Rary.
To Gary.
To Gary.
That sounds like to Duckin.
To Duckin.
You know
Gary, Gary's. Gary's.
Terry.
Terry. There you go, Terry or Garay's.
And then what's Paul? Paul and Therese?
Tall.
Tall. Tall or Terry? Dun dun dun! Comment down below who you ship. Hashtag Tall or hashtag Terry. Leisha asks, there are some tough stuff coming up for Tyler and his brothers. Was it difficult to film and did it take a toll on you?
We find out that one of us Brennan boys is not Russell's son.
Isn't a Brennan
boy. No. So one of us, yes, is brought up in a lie, which is not good. And then we go into other deep stuff that I can't talk about because I don't want to give it away.
You've got a really big year.
Yeah. But difficult film? Yes. Did it take a toll on you? Especially the long days from, you know, start to finish, and then you're just so exhausted by the time you finish. You just want to go home, jump into bed, but you go home, you learn the lines, and then you jump into bed. You just want to switch off. And sometimes you can, sometimes you can't.
And also it was good, like, it was a storyline that you had with all the boys. It was like all of you were doing it together, so you all had support during
For everyone.
It. And also Zoe, who, Faye.
Zoe plays Faye,
She's
which
amazing.
Is our mother.
She
She's so gorgeous.
Very supportive.
She's beautiful. Lauren says, do you have any dream role or a person you'd love to work with?
Yes! So, my dream role, I think I'm a little bit too old now, but I don't know, if I like lost 20 kilos, I might look
She wants
like
to be one of the Teletubbies.
I would love to play Lolita in the remake of Lolita. They're not doing it, but I'd fund it.
How old is the character?
So she's like 14, 15.
Yeah, it's getting a bit late for that.
I reckon if I like toned up heaps and lost like, and I could look 14.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah, people...
Anyway, but the book, she like grows up throughout the movie.
Okay.
Or throughout the book as well. So my dream role would be Lolita or a voice in the Laker films. So they're my favorite films. So Coraline, Box Trolls and Paranorman are my three favourite movies of all time. And
Box Trolls. The book or the movie?
The movie.
The movie, yeah.
I actually enjoyed that. I would love to be a voice in one of those Laker films. And I would love to work with Ezra Miller.
Oh, God, here we go.
No, you don't understand, Trav. He is just...
Title board, 20 minutes later.
Incredible.
Stop drooling.
Yeah, so they're my answers. Lolita, voice
Lolita,
in Laker films.
Box Troll.
I want to be Lolita or a Box Troll. And I will work with Ezra Miller one day. You wait and see.
Mark your words.
Mark my words. Kelly, question. What has been your favourite type of scene or episode to film? Oh, this is really cute.
There's probably been a couple, I reckon. Mm-hmm. I reckon when we got, finally, after everything, we got together, it was at the
Rotunda,
just after Brad and Lauren's wedding. Super cute scene. Favourite. What else has been recently? So caught up with this family stuff.
That kitchen scene, that, like, it didn't kitchen. Come out when, remember, with the crutch?
Oh, yeah.
That didn't come out the way we felt it, but, like, that's, like, the I'll always remember that scene, because that was, like, we had rehearsed it heaps, and then when we did it on the take, we just did it completely differently, and it was just, this sounds so, like,
the white
actor-y.
One,
yeah. But it was really just, good. I felt like I was seeing you for the first time.
After 2 years later. 2 years later.
No, that was really good. What else? Come on, touch.
She's like, finally, you're an actor. You can...
That is not what I was saying. I love night scenes. There's something different
about
the air.
What about all the...
Halloween stuff?
I wasn't involved in that.
Yeah, you were. Remember last year when I confront you at the garage?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
What do you say? That's so you're like... Ago. My heart broke, Piper, or something like that. That kills me, Pipes.
Yeah. What about all the driving lesson ones when I used
to... Oh, they were fun.
Learning
comment down below your favourite type of scene.
Yes, do it.
But yeah,
there's been some good ones. We shot a really, really nice one today.
Even my birthday down at the beach. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What we shot today was good.
Really, really nice. We got some really good stuff coming up as well.
Yeah. Holy... We have huge stuff coming up.
Morgan Dove, is it weird to kiss in front of camera?
I don't find it weird.
I don't find it weird.
Like my first on screen, like, oh, it's so funny.
Put your coffee down, this is a serious conversation right now.
It is. I was doing, when I was in the UK last.
I don't get what that was, but that's okay.
No, just, like, I was like, they said, like, what's been your favorite kiss with Trav, and I was like, this is a weird question.
It's an odd question.
But I was like, probably our first ever kiss, because that was like my first, that was our first kiss ever.
Yep.
And it was like my first ever on-screen kiss. But now, literally, it'll be like, pick up a glass of water and then kiss.
Say this line.
It's the exact same thing.
Where we'll, what are we doing? We're playing Death by Dice.
Mm.
That's right. Mm. And you had your pink and blue.
My God, who remembers that? Psy4724. Or is it CY4724?
Depends which way you look at it.
What's the most annoying thing about each other?
She's mean to me all the time. I'm sorry.
It's only because.
Shut up!
No, I know that.
I know.
I know. That
no, I am like, mean to him.
I'm not mean to him. I'm just in a way that, like, I'm comfortable and we're so familiar with each other that, like, you know, when you, like, you can be mean to your family because, like, they're gonna love you unconditionally. No, I am mean to you.
A little bit.
And I'm a bit moody. No. Glad I said it.
Glad you said that.
You know what? If there was something that really annoyed the both of us, we probably wouldn't be a couple on screen anymore. Because it's all about chemistry.
Absolutely.
We are good friends, hence why it works on the show, hence why we're still together. Name another couple that's like our age that has been a couple long on the show.
For a long period.
We make it work, babe. If you haven't already, subscribe to the Neighbours YouTube page.
Yep. Comment down below. Tell us what you actually thought of her joke. If you thought it was funny, you didn't get it.
Make sure you go back
Please
to part one.
Please be honest.
But yeah.
That's it.
That's it. Bye, guys.
See you guys.
Hey, guys. Hope you enjoyed this week's video. While you're here, you may as well hit the subscribe button and check out some of our other content, maybe a backstage video or a cheeky Q&A. All right, bye, guys. Whoa!